was our first year. We were at States, and it was Saturday morning, and the students come up in the stands, and we can't get the robot to go. And it's like, well, we got to fix this. And he looks at me, and I just handed him the screwdriver. And these kids are all working on the robot, and the kids are talking to the judges. They've got it all under control, first year team. And they got the robot fixed. And it's just like, okay, these kids can do it.
My most memorable moment has been winning the district competition on our home field. We had a group of kids who built the robot, had seen some tough challenges, we like to talk about it, and how they overcame them, had to rebuild a robot, and actually ended up winning the whole competition.
I've definitely seen them come together a lot as a team. Like, I've seen a lot more teamwork, which I think is really neat, just because at the beginning of the season, the kids don't know each other, you know? So it's just cool to see them all come together and really work together and learn to rely on one another to get certain things done.
They get a lot of book learning and some practical experiences in a chemistry lab or writing assignments, but it's different. When they write a brochure that speaks to the parents in one language, but then the kids in the next paragraph, they finally get what the importance of marketing is or the difference they're making in their marketing materials. And when you put out 200 brochures and there's only 35 left by the end of the night, that's their measure of success.
Working with these kids, it's something I can bring to the party. It's something they got an interest in, and it's something I can go and I can help them with.
I'm not an engineer, so I would be classified as a NEMO, which is a non-engineering mentor. Seeing the excitement on the kids' faces when they actually create something and watch it go to competition, that's what I live for.
I think robotics is a great way to get kids exposed to that and help them kind of figure out, is this something they want to do for their life? Is engineering something they're interested in? Or even just, like, you know, software development, anything really. It's just a great way to help kids get exposed to more.
You get to teach, you get to learn, and just it's wonderful just to help a child who doesn't understand how to use a tool, right? Who doesn't understand how to read a meter, to teach them. So it can be life lessons for the mentor as well as life lessons for the mentee, the students, to gain a life skill.
I like to give of my time and my talent because I feel that I have a much greater impression upon the future of not only our community, but of our country, and ultimately with robotics, since it's a world competition, I know that we have a world impact as well. The most exciting moment was actually something that's very small. It's seeing someone who comes in wanting to participate in robotics, and in 6 weeks we get them from being just sort of playing on the sidelines to actually creating either a robot or a marketing collateral piece, and them taking ownership and smiling because 6 weeks ago they didn't even think they could do this, and now they've proven to themselves that they're actually one of the leaders.
Like, when you can actually see them learning, where they go from a moment of like, I don't understand this, and you're standing there as a volunteer and you're like, well, I'm not going to feed you the answer, and you have to kind of walk them through how to solve problems or different things to look at and just kind of wait for them to come to that realization of, oh, I get it now. It's probably the coolest thing.
Bottom line, recruitment, right? So this is a way that we could go out, help the community, as well as retain some of these young people after they graduate from college.
Whirlpool wants those kids, engineering students that have been through FIRST are good. And we want those good people. Whirlpool needs those good people in engineering.
And we have some open positions that have been open for 12, 18 months. So why not just keep the people we already have, train them so that they come back and work for us and stay in the area?
Regardless of whether or not they work for us in the future or not, they're going to develop technologies that we're going to use if we're going to survive as a corporation. And we need to expand that base to keep our pipeline full.
Do it. Simply do it. I mean, it's refreshing, it's life-changing. As a volunteer, the only skill set you need is the heart and the willingness to volunteer.
I mean, when I was first going to volunteer, I was like, well, I'm not sure how much I'm going to be able to contribute or if I'm going to be able to help at all. And then I'm like, well, this is a silly fear to have. I'm never going to know unless I try. So that's like what was holding me back. So I think the biggest thing is what's holding you back.